watching me fuck was like retaliation.
My sisters watching me F was like retaliation. I'm not gonna even say anything about that. Finally out, the Kendrick album is out, and today this is going to be my initial analysis of it, initial review of it. I don't feel anybody in their right senses can listen to this album within the weekend and have a whole review of it. I don't think it's possible. Anyway, without much talking, I'm so happy to do this. Like, I actually try to steer away from things like this that's coming from the States, because I don't want to talk much about it. But also, this one, right, I just wanted to do it. I really, really just want to do it. When it comes to the music reaction and the breakdowns, your environment, where you're coming from and all that, is going to much more like have an effect. Your environment is going to have a major effect on how you understand the lyrics and how they affect you personally. This one right here, I was just like, hey, I don't know how it's going to turn out, but I think other people would also want to know how an African reacts or relates to the words that he's saying in the music. So yeah, I'm just out here to do it. From my perspective, cannot be the same as yours, obviously, but I think I'm talking too much. Not much talking though. I can't wait to do this one right here. It's crazy. Hey, it's me. It's me. It's not your perspective. You came here to watch it. Not much talking. Let's do it. Bro, come on. In this lifetime. This just set the whole mood for me. It's a crazy way to begin the whole album. Like, I hope you find some peace of mind in this lifetime. I hope you find some peace of mind, whatever that you're going through. And to look at it from the perspective, if you've listened to Section 80 or any of his albums, this one right here ties it so much together. Like, you are going through all these things, but as much as you're going through all these things, I hope at the end of the day, you have some peace of mind in this lifetime. And it speaks volumes. That is what I'm trying to say. If you've listened to any of the albums from this gentleman right here, you know this bar right here, it means a lot, because Section 80, all those other albums, all those other tracks out there, and saying you actually, he hopes you find peace of mind. Come on.
Tell him.
Okay.
I've been going through something.
I've been going through something.
1,855
days. 1,855
days.
So the album is going to be a compoundment of what he's been going through for the 1,855 or 65, whatever. And if you actually calculate, that makes it exactly 5 years. And y'all know it's been 5 years since he released an album. So I don't know about you, but this few like minutes into the album, it's not even minutes, like 32 seconds, I'm just checking it, these few 32 seconds, like, bro, it's going to be a lot. Because think about it, 5 years, this is like a 5-year body of work. It's going to be a lot to digest. That's what I'm saying. I don't think anybody can do a good job with like just a weekend and come out with something better. Hey, I think I'm talking too much. I'm not going to do a whole in-depth analysis of it. So this one right here was United by Grief, and bro, you have to listen to it for yourself. I'm going to move on to the next one. I don't want this video to be a very long video though. And so let's start. The next one, this one is like N95.
And on hello N95, new world, listen. All the boys and girls, okay. I got some true stories to tell. You're back outside.
Bro. You have to listen to it. I'm going to skip a few minutes in. I told you, I don't want the video to be monetized. It's just me showing how I like the music though and how it speaks to me. I'll be talking about a little bit of the lyrics in here and there. And hey, if y'all want to see the African perspective of it, like how I relate to these bars, maybe you can leave a comment down there and I'll do a whole reaction or review of some of the tracks. I don't know. Hey, I do mostly music from Africa, but today we out here, we're doing it anyway.
Microwave memes, it's a real world outside. Take off your idols, take off the runway, take off the Cairo. Take off the sandal, pay 5 days day, take off for the meal and the final. Take off the first flag, take off reception, take off the pack with the iPad. Take off the unload, take off the unsure, take off.
Bro, this one right here, what I liked about it is like, when he started with the take off this, take off that, like take off all these jewelry, take off all these things. I was like, why is he going to go with that? Then he goes like, you're nothing. If you have to take off all these things that you own and it's just you, you are nothing. And it speaks volumes. You know how people are just chasing after stuff, right? Everybody wants to have the biggest and the greatest. Everybody wants, I don't know, it's like the new stuff. But then he's like, when we take all these things off, who are you? Listen to this track right here, N95. You really, really gonna love it. And I think the best part I like about it was when he was talking about cancel culture. I don't know if I can be able to find that, but hey, let's just go. I'll play a little bit somewhere in the middle again. This ain't monogamy, y'all getting fucked. Living on what the hell is that? I gotta relax when I feel. All my descendants, they come in my sleep and say I am too real. Bro, hey, I don't get a video demonetized. I'm trying to look for the cancel culture, but I think it's somewhere getting to the end of the whole thing. The actual, I can't find it. But then it was like, what the fuck is, oh bro, this video is just about getting the money. He was like, why the F is cancel culture? He's going to say what he wants to say anyway. And how many people do you know that can put such a bar in the music? Like, what is cancel culture? Everybody is getting canceled left, right, center. And you have this gentleman going like, hey, I don't know what this is about. What is about though? I'm going to say anything that I have to say. I like it. N95 is what it seems to be like my second favorite, because there's one on there which I just can't do without. So that was N95. He's talking a whole lot of shit and then questioning a lot of stuff too. Moving on to the next one, bro. Let's keep moving. I may not even do the whole thing.
Kodak
right?
Black.
Hold on. This is Kodak. Kodak Black is going to come in and this is going to do a little bit of an intro. Wait, hold on. I'm not going to do the whole list of the tracks on the album. I'm just going to pick some of them, those that spoke to me a lot, and just speak a little bit about it. Like I said, if you want to see me do a whole review or a whole reaction video, let me know. So I pick some of the music on there and just do it. This one was Worldwide Steppers. Kodak will come and do his intro. Keep it moving.
Black for 2 years, nothing more.
No, I'm still trying to find that.
I don't think like I used to. No, I don't blink like I used to.
I don't blink like I used to. And he'll talk about when I expire, my children will make high valleys. Bro, when he expires, his children is going to make. Tell me, how are you going to listen to this within a week and try and understand whatever that he's saying? I think on this track right here, too, he also had a bar which goes like, I'm trying to find it. Yeah. I would rather want to play that one, no matter what. I think I have to try to find that.
Good kid, Mad yeah. City tour. I flourished on the stages. When he asked that I have a problem, I said yeah. I might be racist. Ancestors watching me fuck was like retaliation.
My ancestors watching me F was like retaliation. I'm not going to even say anything about that. My ancestors watching me. So he is effing a white and then his ancestors watching him F is like retaliation. What the F? Listen to this one again. If you skipped it, Worldwide Steppers, go back and listen to it again. It's crazy hard. It's crazy hard. And I don't think anyone else can play this one on radio. Because, bro, the F-bomb left, right, center, it's everywhere. Skipping on, moving on to the next one, which was like Die Hard. Bro, this one right here, This one right here. I think this is by far the one that I like most on the album. I actually don't have anything to say about this one right here because like I was just jamming to it. Just listen to me. Huh? Listen. How are you going to listen to this and have anything to say about it? Listen. I was trying to listen to this like, I've listened to it like 10 times. When I was listening, I was trying to write something down so when I'm doing this initial review, I would have something to say. But this is what happened. Anytime I listen to it, I'll just drop the pen and just be jamming. It's so nice. This one right here, the vibe that it gives and that bumpy feel to it, like that bouncing feel to it. Crazy nice. Listen to a little bit of it again.
I hope you see the God in me.
I hope you see the God in me.
And if it's up, stay down for
come
me.
Come on.
Yeah.
Bro. This one right here, go listen to it for yourself. Get some nice piece of headset or a big loud speaker. Get your woman and dance to this one right here. Crazy tune. Telling you. So far, I can't take anything from the album. Crazy body of work. Like he said, 1,865 or 55 days. It's crazy. Everything on here is crazy. Let's just move on to the next one. Father Time. This one right here. If I want to talk about this one right here, it's going to take like hours because this is deep. This is a lot. Grown men with father issues, I guess. This is so deep. Let me try to find it's so difficult trying to find places on, how do you call it, on YouTube. But I'll do it anyway. Like I said, I do mostly African music, but this one right here, I'm going to do it anyway. Keep it moving.
Daddy issues all across my head. Told me fuck a foul, I'm teary-eyed. Wanna throw my hands, I won't think out loud. A foolish pride if I lose.
Bro, daddy issues. And this one right here, a couple of the bars I got from my first listen was like, grown men with daddy issues, and it's like, hide my emotions, never express myself. Hi. Is it not S.O.? Is it not S.O.? Trying to be the macho man kind of a people, not trying to express that much of emotions? The only emotion that we show is the toughness. All the other emotions we push aside. That line right there. And also he talked about trust nobody on your but your mama. And now relationships are that hard. Like there's a bar like that in there. Whereby growing up, all that you perceive is you can trust anyone. The only person that you can trust is your mom. Now you get into a relationship with other females and it's like you still tied to your mom. Sort of. It's S.O. Like, it's everybody out there. Everybody out there. It's everybody out there. Crazy. Like, that's what I keep saying. I don't think anybody can listen to this in just these couple of days that it's been out and have, like, a review that makes sense. You can't. Anyway, let me play something. I can't find the places, but hey, play a little bit of it. We keep it moving.
Bro, I got daddy issues that's on me.
Anyway, that was daddy issues right there. And let's keep going. Rich spirit, no, let's go to this one right here. We cry together. Where is it? We cry together. Yeah, we cry together. Crazy one. Listen, I'm gonna tell you something nice about this one right here. This one right here, sorry. I'm not going to make a play. Skip ahead a little bit again. You know how we do it?
I swear I'm tired of these emotional ass, ungrateful ass bitches. Unstable ass, confrontational ass.
I'm scared of these emotional. This one right here, if you want me to talk about it, this is a movie to me. This is a movie to me. So when I was listening to, I didn't even listen. What I did was like, close my eyes this way, and then just in my mind's eye, I was watching it. I could see it. Listen, try it too. Try it. Don't just put on your headset or just play the music. Find a quiet place. Just lay down, close your eyes, and try to visualize it. This is a whole movie. I'm telling you. It's. I can't play it because this one also it has a whole lot of the F-bombs. It's going to get a video demonetized. But go, put your headset on, close your eyes, and try to visualize this one right here. Kendrick Lamar, We Cry Together. Crazy. And also, the lady on the track, though, is it Taylor Page? Woo! That lady is an actress. Like, she really goes down. It's this one right here. I don't think anything beats it. I think it's my favorite. Because, bro, the experience I got from it was crazy. Just laying down there, looking at both perspectives of that guy and the lady. Also, to talk about how it ended, though. When the lady's like, F me, he's like, F me. They're both going at each other, like, and they end up effing. I think you know what I mean. So it's like the whole thing repeats itself, right? The whole thing, the whole drama repeats itself. Because at the end of the day, they end up effing. So this whole abusive whatever these two people are in is going to repeat it itself. And the next day is going to be F you, and they end up, yeah. How the trauma really lives on. This one right here, close your eyes, just visualize it. It's a movie. Keep it moving. Which one am I going to even talk about again? I think I'll talk about Purple Hearts. Where is it? Let me try to find it. Purple Hearts. Purple. Oh. Why can't I find it? Yeah. Purple Hearts. Let's go. Bro. Purple Hearts is a gem to me. I think what I like most of Purple Hearts right here is Ghostface. Yeah, his verse from right there, it's sick. It's been a minute I heard anything from him. And the verse on here right
there. Finding a small portion of faded pictures, this global madness, the intervention, this world's in the twilight zone. This is the fifth dimension. God,
please blow the whistle. We need an
God, please blow the whistle. We need an intermission. Ghostface Killah verse on Purple Hearts is just perfect. I love it so much. It's a good lesson. You have to listen to it. And like, with this album, I think I'm going to keep repeating. When you're listening to it, it has a whole lot of quotables. So all you need is get a piece of pen and paper. And as you listen to it, you write things down. Because it's a lot. I can't go through it all. If I was to talk about something again, I think I'll talk about Mirror, which is like the last one on the album. And hey, I didn't want this video to be this long though. But then already looking at my timer here, it's like 16 minutes in. Kendrick Lamar, the album is out. The Big Steppers, bro, crazy, crazy body of work. And to end up, it's like, how do I even say it? The beats on the track, they are bold and these are not dark. You know how you have these muddy beats? No, these are like light and they are bold. There are very few rappers that would actually want to try something like this because it's like experimental. They are bold, light, and new. I'm trying to go through my head to find a word to explain how I felt about the beats and whatever. It's new. It's like everything out here was sounding the same with the mambo raps. Everything out here was just sounding the same. But this one right here is nothing like you are ever going to hear on anything. The production, A+. Like, and the personalities that he puts on it. Like, you're going to have a track and you're going to have like three Kendricks on there, different personalities altogether. But, hey, a great body of work. This is just my initial view of it. I'm going to listen to it again. If y'all would want me to do like a reaction video of any of these music tracks right there, just to see my perspective on it as a Black African, hey, I'm down to do it. I like it. I like the album a lot. Anyway, without much talking, hey, I'm the Dope Man, the Bars Man, Dan Heights. I just have to check it out. Not much talking though. Catch you on next time. Same time, somewhere else in a different music video. Until next time. Bye-bye.